Are we alone in the universe? This is one of the most fascinating questions ever, and I personally ask it to myself every time I watch the sky at night. While we cannot give a precise answer to this question yet, you may be surprised to hear that we may have already received a communication from space. In fact, in 1977, astronomers detected a signal that may have been sent from an alien civilization. Do you want to hear more about that? Watch this video, and I will tell you. Our story starts in 1973 at the Ohio State University, where the radio telescope named Big Ear was assigned to look at the sky, searching for signs of extraterrestrial life as part of the SETI project. A radio telescope is like a giant antenna, able to detect radio waves, the electromagnetic waves with the longest wavelength. About 4 years later, on the night of August 15, 1977, something unexpected happened. The radio telescope detected a signal that was different from any other previously observed. The first person who realized this was the astronomer Jerry Emmon a few days later. While he was analyzing the data from Big Ear, Emmon observed a sudden jump in the intensity of the signal recorded by the telescope at 22:16 Eastern Time on the night of August 15th. The signal recorded by the detector was measured over an interval of 12 seconds and then printed out as a single character corresponding to the average of the intensity of the signal over each interval. Therefore, the output analyzed by Emmon was a sequence of characters, each of them representing the average intensity of the signal every 12 seconds. The characters used in this system were the following. A space indicated a signal intensity of 0, numbers between 1 and 9 indicated increasing intensity, while signals with intensity of 10 or above were represented using letters A, corresponded to a signal intensity of 10, B to a signal intensity of 11, and so on. Normally, the printouts analyzed by Emmon only contained a mix of space characters together with the digits 1 and 2, representing low-intensity signals corresponding to background noise. However, while checking the data from August 15th, Emmon was shocked by finding a sequence of 6 consecutive characters very different from the rest, 6EQJ5. He was so surprised when he found this sequence that he circled it and he wrote the word WOW next to it. Consequently, this signal later became known as WOW signal. As we said before, each character represents the average intensity of the signal over 12 seconds. So this sequence of 6 characters corresponds to a signal of 72 seconds in total. However, this doesn't mean that the real signal coming from space lasted 72 seconds. In fact, Big Ear was configured to watch towards a fixed direction, relying on the rotation of the Earth to scan across the sky. Considering the speed of the Earth's rotation and the size of the telescope, this means that Big Ear could observe a given point in space only for 72 seconds. So the WOW sequence, 6EQUJ5, was recorded during the time window in which the telescope was observing the region of space where this signal came from. 72 seconds later, Big Ear was already pointing to another portion of sky, and so the signal disappeared. The recorded intensity increases in the first half of the sequence, 6EQ, and then decreases in the second half, UJ5, with a peak of 30 at the center, in correspondence of the letter U. These two facts together mean that the signal observed by Big Ear was continuous, and with a duration of at least 72 seconds, possibly more. However, we also know that the signal lasted less than 3 minutes. In fact, Big Ear consisted of 2 feed horns, observing the same portion of the sky 3 minutes apart from each other. The WOW signal, however, was detected by one of the 2 horns only. If it was longer than 3 minutes, both horns should have observed it. Where did this signal come from? Given the design of the telescope, it was not possible to determine which of the 2 horns detected the signal, so there is a small ambiguity in the determination of the precise location. However, we know for sure that it came from somewhere in the direction of the constellation Sagittarius, very close to the plane of the ecliptic, which is the plane that contains both the Sun and the Earth's orbit. Emmett and others later tried several times to watch again that same portion of the sky, but the wow signal was never detected again. What is so special about this signal, and why is it a possible candidate for an alien radio transmission? To answer this question, we need to look at the characteristics of this signal. First of all, its frequency. The frequency of the wow signal is approximately 1420 MHz. This value is very special in nature because it corresponds to the frequency of the radio waves emitted by neutral hydrogen gas in space. Since hydrogen is the most abundant element in the universe, scientists believe it is natural for any civilization to choose this frequency to transmit a message into space. In reality, the frequency of the wow signal was slightly higher than the frequency of emission of the neutral hydrogen. It is possible that this discrepancy is due to a blue shift. This is a phenomenon that occurs when the object emitting the signal is moving towards us. In that case, the frequency of the signal as observed on the Earth is higher than the real frequency. If that was the case, scientists calculated that the source of the signal should have been moving towards the Earth at a speed of 10 kilometers per second, about 36,000 kilometers per hour. Although this may seem like a huge value, this is very similar to the speed of some of the space probes that we sent in space. The two Voyagers, for example, are currently traveling at a speed of just above 15 kilometers per second. Another interesting characteristic of the wow signal is that it is very narrow band. Generally, natural sources in space emit radio waves across different frequencies. This is called broad spectrum, but this is not true for the wow signal. In fact, Big Ear had a receiver containing 50 different channels, each of them able to detect a different frequency. Still, only one channel saw the signal, indicating that it was very narrow and concentrated around a single frequency. It is interesting to note that this is more similar to the kind of signals emitted by radio stations for communications on Earth, which are indeed narrowband. It is not clear what kind of natural source can emit such a narrowband signal. At this point, one may wonder whether this wow signal may have actually originated on Earth, and perhaps reflected towards the radio telescope by a satellite. This is very unlikely, essentially for two reasons. First, the frequency of 1420 MHz is a protected frequency because of its important connection to hydrogen. This means that no radio communications on Earth are allowed to use this frequency to let radio astronomers do their studies without interference. So it is very unlikely that somebody on Earth was transmitting messages at this frequency in 1977. Second, given the shape of the signal detected by Big Ear, scientists calculated that the source of the signal must have been at least as distant from the Earth as the Moon. So even if we assume that somebody broadcasted this message from the Earth at a frequency of 1420 MHz, this should have been reflected by a satellite at least as distant from the Earth as the Moon. This is very unlikely since all satellites that we know orbit the Earth much closer than that. So now that we have seen the characteristics of the wow signal, we may ask, what are possible explanations of its nature? Before finding out the answer to this question, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve and make these videos better for you, the viewer. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel, clicking the bell so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. So what are the possible explanations about the origin of the wow signal? One hypothesis is that the signal was just a result of an interstellar scintillation. This is a phenomenon that occurs when radio waves produced by some celestial object are randomly scattered and amplified by the interstellar medium. It's like the twinkling of the light of a star at night when we watch the sky, but with radio waves instead of visible light. If that was the case, it is possible that one of the two feed horns of Big Ear was watching the right part of the sky just at the right time, but the signal was no longer amplified when the other feed horn observed the same patch of sky. However, this explanation does not entirely convince scientists, especially because such a signal should have been observed also by the Very Large Array Observatory in New Mexico, already operating at that time, which is much more sensitive than Big Ear to this type of signal. Another hypothesis is that the signal is just the result of a gravitational lensing, according to the theory of general relativity by Einstein, massive objects create strong gravitational fields, producing a curvature in the space-time. As a result, the path followed by light or any other electromagnetic radiation, such as radio waves, passing nearby a massive object is not straight, but curved. This phenomenon is known as gravitational lensing. So it is possible that the wow signal actually came from a different location than the one in which Big Ear was observing, and it was quickly gravitationally lensed by a natural object passing in between. But this hypothesis doesn't sound very likely either, because it's very unlikely that this effect lasted that briefly, and the signal should have been observed by the second feed horn as well. A third possible explanation was proposed more recently, in 2017. Perhaps the wow signal originated by the hydrogen cloud surrounding two comets, namely 266P Christensen and 335P Gibbs, that were not catalogued at that time yet. However, scientists are also skeptical about this possibility. In fact, the two comets didn't seem to be located in the right direction at the time of the observation of the wow signal. Moreover, it is not clear how they could produce a signal visible in only one of the 2 feed horns of the telescope. As we also explained earlier, any Earth-related origin for the wow signal seems also not very likely. So what is it? The truth is, we don't know. There are dozens of other possible hypotheses, but none of them sound very convincing to scientists. The wow signal may have been produced by a natural source in rotation around its axis, so that the signal was pointing in our direction only for a limited time, or a source producing signals of variable frequency and so on. But after all, the most fascinating hypothesis still holds. It is possible that the signal was not produced by any natural source, and its origin was artificial instead. If this is the case, we can say that the wow signal may have been the first successful communication we ever received from an alien civilization. And in this case, that short sequence of 6 characters represents the answer to one of the greatest questions. Are we alone in the universe? That's all for this video. Thanks for watching, everyone. Did you find the story of the wow signal fascinating? Do you believe it was really a message sent by an alien civilization? Or was it just the result of some unknown natural process? Do you want to know more about this topic? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.